You know, this is a not what you think it is, but it's not as bad as you might expect. The martial arts kid is not a Karate Kid ripoff. It sure does follow a lot of those same storylines and dynamics, but it's different. They got some high-named martial artists in here that I didn't really hear of until now. Then again, maybe it's more East Coast. I live in the West, in Nevada, so I live up in the mountains. So for me, the visuals are great when it comes to seeing shots of Florida. I'm going to talk about the movie without spoilers first before I really get into it, because this isn't what you expect it to be, honestly. I went in this movie with a filmmaker's background and a martial artist background, and I have to say, it's pretty good. I recommend it if you want to show your kids something to inspire them. It's like Star Wars. It likes to draw the line between the good and the bad, whereas martial artists are good, MMA fighters are bad. What's the difference between a martial artist and a fighter? Yeah, there are pretty drastic differences, but not all fighters are kind of the way this movie lays it out to be. I mean, I've met MMA fighters that have a great morals. They just like to get in the cage. They like to fight, but their morals are still strong and good, so not everyone is in that mindset. But for a family-friendly movie, it does its job pretty well. There's a lot of cringe-worthy stuff, but I guess I should go over the story a little bit before going into that. Pretty much, in The Martial Arts Kid, there is a kid named Robbie. Robbie moves from Ohio to Florida. He hung out with the wrong crowd. He's trying to fit in with his aunt and his uncle by moving away, and he's trying to build a new life. Upon joining martial arts, which he finds out his Uncle Ben and Aunt Cindy run a karate school together, his whole mentality changes. He wants to be better. He wants to get the girl he likes. And of course, there's some conflict. And in the end, he's able to get the girl and be happy on the beach together. That's about as non-spoiler I can go. There's a whole lot more details in there, but I'm just gonna leave it at that, because that's all you really need to know. There's not too much. I mean, just reading the back of the DVD cover, it kind of tells you the whole movie as it is. If you've seen The Karate Kid, it's nothing really new, but it's a refreshing take upon that same story. We've seen Karate Kid told, God, like 4 times now. We've had Karate Kid, The Next Karate Kid of Jackie Chan and Jaden Smith, and now we have The Martial Arts Kid. And I have to say, this one is one of my favorites. I mean, there's not a whole lot to pick from, but I like it a lot. I give it a B-. I'd watch it again. It has some pretty high-name martial artists in there. Like I said, we had Don the Dragon Wilson. He is a professional kickboxer and has different black belts. Same with Cynthia Rothrock. I mean, my bad. Excuse me for mispronouncing that. Cynthia Rothrock. She is a forms master, has black belts in katas, taekwondo, and she is a professional fighter as far as in karate tournaments. She has a lot of good stuff going for her too, and she's very likable, not just as her portraying herself in the movie, but as her portraying her character. They're both very likable. Same with Glenn. Sorry, Uncle Glenn. Don Dragon Wilson, he's very likable too. And of course, the villains are very hateable. Like the guy who plays Bo, he's that typical high school scumbag and are about to graduate and all. To make it really quick before I really dive into it, the director of photography, all the shots are beautiful. There are a few that make you go, eh. Like some of the I have to shake the camera type of movement. All right, and some of the writing is, dare I say it's Star Wars Episode 2 cringeworthy, but it's not that bad. You can tell it feels more like a home movie, but it's just some of the writing. I feel like the writing could have been a little stronger. It always suffers from the same part of, did you read that out loud? I think some of the lines, if they were read out loud before they just went and shot it, it could have been stronger. So maybe a little more practice, maybe more of an acting coach there. And then the music's pretty spot on. I was expecting a different type of music going into like the whole final battle arc and everything, but I had to watch it twice. Because after watching it the second time, it's actually pretty good. It fits. I mean, it's not my favorite type of music, but it fits really well. I can see why the music won awards. I can see why the movie won awards. And as a spoiler for your review, I give it a B-. It's good. Now I'm going to dive really deep into it. If you care for spoilers, then, well, stop watching now. Otherwise, I'm really going to get deep into it because there's a lot more to it. But it's definitely a B- movie. And rent it first. Watch it on Amazon Prime or however, or Amazon Video, my bad. Because I don't think it's on Netflix. I tried searching there myself. It's pretty good. Now, on to the fun part. What a lot of the movie does right, it also does wrong. But I don't mean that in a bad way. It means I would have liked a slightly different approach with how some of the situations were assessed. I mainly wanted conflict between Robbie and Rena. Hey, they both start with R's. But it all starts with the relationship going, oh, well, I'm sorry I'm dating that scumbag. I know you work for my father now, but, you know, he got to me first 2 months ago. But I really, really like you. And, you know, let's go hang out at the zoo and I'm going to hold your arm and totally tease you about it. Because I know you like me too. Why? Why are we doing this? And then they take pictures together. Then she ends up breaking up with the bad guy, Bo. And then they get together, which, don't get me wrong, it's pretty freaking adorable. And after they get together, it's, oh, now Robbie destroyed that gift you gave me. Not Robbie, my bad. Now Bo destroyed that gift you gave me. Yeah, their names mixed up. And I'm heartbroken, please come meet and comfort me. And then Robbie goes on a rampage, beats up a bunch of his friends. And at first I'm going, oh my god, what are you doing? You just throw that whole martial arts mentality right out the window. I don't care if his friends are bad. You don't go out there looking to pick a fight. Martial artists don't do that. And I was expecting some, what the hell did you do? Why did you do that? You're in a lot of trouble. If you want to get back to this guy, we'll arrange something so it's one-on-one together. And then you guys can make amends there. I was expecting more of that approach for the end instead of what we got. Don't get me wrong, it's still really cool, and it's pretty freaking sweet to see a bunch of martial artists lined up together and a bunch of MMA fighters lined up together and then them both going at it at the end of the movie. That was pretty freaking sweet, even though it is a really gray-lined type of movie. It's like Star Wars, you have the good guys and got the bad guys. And that's also kind of what bothers me. I've met a lot of MMA fighters growing up in my own martial arts career that they just like the fight. They still have that good morals, that good mentality. They just like to get in the cage, but they're not all about finding someone on the street to beat them up, or, oh, this is my territory, oh, this is mine, I'm gonna beat you up because you looked at me funny. They don't have that kind of mentality. Don't get me wrong, a lot of them do, but a lot of them don't at the same time. And I really, really like to see some more dynamics in there. Like, there are people and they're the one to go like, wait, why are we fighting these guys? What's wrong? And then maybe that guy gets knocked out or something. But now we just portray that there is some good in that school, as bad as it might seem. So I was kind of hoping for more of that, but what we got was not bad either. I also was hoping for some consequences for Robbie's decision, beating up Bo's friends near the end. We didn't. It was more supported than it was a consequence. That's okay too. Overall, with what the movie does well, it does really well. And for what it doesn't really last that long to make you go, ugh, are we really gonna sit through 10 minutes of dialogue? Ugh, it doesn't have any of those types of things. Which is rather refreshing. It has a lot of montages, which I think it pays tribute to a lot of movies in the 80s. The original Karate Kid had a couple of montages. So paying tribute to that was pretty funny. There's also another tribute to the Karate Kid where Robbie is washing his uncle's car. He goes, "Oh good, did Aunt Cindy have you wash my car?" "Oh no, I just feel like washing it." "Oh, okay, cool. You know I'm not buying you a car, right? You're not gonna drive any of ours." "Oh, yeah, I just feel like washing it, cool." And, you know, hold on. I'm totally butchering those lines. But overall, it's like paying tribute to the Karate Kid where he's like, "Oh, no wax, right?" As he's like going in circular motions washing the car. It's funnier than it actually looks. If you watch the trailer, it totally captures that funny moment. I completely butchered it. I'm not the best at comedy, I apologize. But it's funny. It has a lot of funny moments. Makes you laugh a lot of places, it makes you smile a lot of places, there's a lot of heartwarming stuff. Like, you want to see more of the cafe Aunt Cindy works at, you want to see more of the past with her and Uncle Glenn. You want to see why Bo came up to where he's at. Because you kind of see the father at the end, and that's where the major cliffhanger is. After they're all standing at the beach, the father of Bo is on like this boat, and they're looking at him. He goes, "Well, what are you gonna do, Dad?" It's like, "Oh, we're gonna make him feel pain." Like, okay, that's kind of cheesy, but it sets up for the martial arts kid too. The return of Bo or something. And I'd give it a watch. As far as the action scenes go, because I know a lot of people are gonna be wondering what I think of the action. Don't get me wrong, it's actually really good. It's more realistic than I thought it was gonna be. I was expecting some more action stuff to be drawn out. There is a guy in the parking lot when Cindy is giving Robbie a cell phone that he pulls a knife on her. She wipes him out fast and very effective. I like it. I think that bad guy could use a little more acting there, but overall it was pretty freaking sweet, don't get me wrong. And then like her fighting some bullies on the beach is pretty sick too. A lot of the action is more realistic, which I think is done rather well. There's only a few shots to where I would have liked the camera to have been backed up, or for it to not sit on that close-up as long as it has. Upon watching many Kung Fu films, if there are a lot of close-ups, you see the close-ups of the hands or the kick, and then it backs up, whether in movement or it cuts to a shot further back. And I feel like those kind of cuts are good. I'm not sure if the filmmakers behind this movie had a whole lot of martial arts film background as far as researching and seeing what is popular in today's media. But what they did and did well is really well. They had a pretty good fight choreographer choreographed this movie. I never heard of the guy. No, I can't find his name, but the fight choreographer did a pretty good job. I like how realistic a lot of the scenes are. One thing that disappointed me with that whole final battle arc is you want to see more of just Robbie and the bully. It cuts between all the martial arts, the MMA fighters going at each other. But at the same time, it doesn't show exactly what you want. And then there's a really nice, like, 5-7 minute fight scene between Uncle Glenn and the leader of the bad dojo, pretty much. They fight in, like, this... what's it, like a baseball practice area where you go in, you hit baseballs, like a batting ring. That's what I'm looking for. And that's done pretty well. Has some nice long establishing shots in there as far as like it being one long shot of them fighting. There's not a whole lot of cuts. I like that a lot. That was done really freaking well. And then there's another one where they are swinging baseball bats at each other. Metal bats too, which is really freaking dangerous, but they did it rather well. I think they probably got bruised up a little bit doing that scene, but it was done rather well. So the fight scenes, they're pretty good. Some are shorter than I would have liked, others are a little longer than I would have liked, but overall it's realistic, it's great, and there's a lot of good martial arts background in there. I like it a lot, actually. The music fits it well. I'm more into different types of music, honestly, but I think the music that was composed and chosen for the movie and the scenes work well together. So I definitely recommend getting a watch. Don't go into it thinking it's going to be a Donnie Yen Ip Man movie, or a Drunken Fist Jackie Chan, or Bruce Lee's Way of the Dragon. It's not. It's not like that at all. And it's not a complete ripoff of The Karate Kid. I don't think it's ripping off at all. It's a fresh take on it, more or less. It's a different way of telling it. Because in Karate Kid, we had Daniel, who came into this town. He gets beat up. He's angry at his mother. Then he meets the General Miyagi. And then things go better from there. But in this movie, the aunt and the uncle are the mentor roles. And they do that really well. Especially getting professional people who've actually done the martial arts for years into those roles. That's amazing. I like that a lot. What else? I think I mentioned how I wanted more dynamic into the relationship with Robbie and Rena. I wanted more conflict there. But I don't think there's not much more to say. Of course, there's always a couple quick shots. I really wish they just would have went with more movement instead of such quick, snappy camera work on a couple shots. And I really wish they backed it up more. I want to see more of Robbie and Bo going at it in the cage, but it cuts between so many things. But that's okay. It does its job well. It gives you what you'd expect. I wish it did a little more with it. Maybe run the movie on for 5 more minutes. Or change how some scenes played out. But that's okay. My grade stays the same on my spoiler-free part of this review. I give it a B-. Martial Arts Kid is a good family film. If you love martial arts, watch it. If you love movies, watch it. Rent it first. If you like it, heck, you might want to buy it. Because it's a nice movie to add to my collection, even. And for me, martial arts changed my life so drastically in all the good ways. More confidence in myself, more hand-eye coordination, and overall just more positivity. And this film can inspire people to do the same thing. So, hey, give it a watch. It's not what you think it is, and it's not as bad as you might think either. I cut out a little less martial arts cameos in there. They had a lot of martial arts cameos, and I'm researching going, who is all these people? Cut out a little less of them. I think that kind of dragged on a little bit, but I think it hits a home run on like the heartstrings that a movie is supposed to make you feel something. So, B-, give it a watch, and if you have a movie you'd recommend me watching and do a review on, let me know in the comments or send me a message, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good day.